Hey, podcast people. On today's short video, I am going to show you how you can use more than one USB microphone plugged into your computer at the same time to record two separate tracks. All right, let's get to it. Hey, welcome to the Pod Sound School, where we help podcasters make something big with their podcast. I'm Studio Steve, and today I'm going to answer a very commonly asked question, which is how to use more than one USB microphone at the same time, but record them on separate tracks. So for this illustration, I'm just gonna use the Samson Q2U and the Blue Snowball. You can use any USB microphone you want. You can use two of the same USB microphones. You can actually use as many USB microphones as you can plug into your computer. Now, depending on what model of computer you're using, if you're using the new Mac Pro, for example, you might need to get an adapter with the new USB-C cable. And if you don't have enough plugs or USB inputs in your computer, you can get a USB hub that actually gives you multiple USB plugs. So let's just get these plugged in. Okay, so first I'm gonna plug in the Samson Q2U and I'll put it on this little stand that it comes with. And we'll just get it plugged into one of my open USB slots. Beautiful. Okay, and now we plug in the Blue Snowball. So like I said, you can do this with the same type of microphone. You can do this with as many microphones as you have USB plugs, which is really cool. And there we go. You can see that the light has turned on the Samson Q2U and the light has turned on in the Blue Snowball. So to record these at the same time, I'm gonna use Reaper. Reaper is my favorite digital audio workstation for independent podcasters, and it is way superior to Audacity or GarageBand. Now, you can try Reaper out for free for 60 days. So you could try it out with your multiple USB microphones, and then after that 60 days, it's a one-time $60. So it's not a free solution like Audacity or GarageBand, but it's way better than Audacity and GarageBand for many reasons. But this isn't a video about Reaper, this is a video about recording two USB microphones. So let's get to that. So I have these plugged into my computer, so I'm just gonna open up Reaper. So here's Reaper. As I said, it's really easy to download Reaper, very quick to download Reaper. And this is what it looks like when you first open up Reaper. You can set up two audio tracks here, just like this. And these two audio tracks are going to be what are going to record these two microphones separately. But before I do that, I'm gonna need to go into the Reaper preferences right here. And from Reaper preferences, I'm going to navigate to where it says audio device. And from device, you'll see audio device here. From this drop-down menu, I can see all the audio devices that are plugged into my computer. I've got the Samson Q2U, I have the Blue Snowball, but how do I select both of these at the same time? Well, to do that, we're actually gonna have to go into here where it says audio MIDI setup. Now, this is just the audio device's audio MIDI setup from your computer. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a new device right here by clicking on this plus button, and we're gonna create an aggregate device. And from this aggregate device, here is where we can choose as many audio interfaces as we want and lump them all together into an aggregate device. So I'm gonna start with the Samson Q2U, and you'll see it has already assigned some input channels for that device. And then I'm going to click on the Blue Snowball, and you'll see that it is now assigned an input channel for the Blue Snowball. So input number 1 and 2 are gonna be my Samson Q2U, and input number 3 is gonna be my Blue Snowball. So that's all I have to do, and now I just X out of this and this aggregate device. I can name this if I want. I'll go ahead and name this 2 USB mics. Okay, and now I know what that aggregate device is, 2 USB mics, and I can exit out of this. When I exit out of this, I'm actually gonna have to exit out of these preferences and go back into it again. So I'll go to Reaper, Preferences, and now from this audio device option, I have something called 2 USB mics, or my aggregate device that we set up. And here I'm gonna say apply and okay. Now when I come down here into Reaper to record these tracks, I can put them in record or arm them to record. And if I arm both of them to record, it will allow me to select the inputs. And look, from right here it says in. From here I can select my inputs, and I have the Samson Q2U. It doesn't really matter if it's left or right on the Samson Q2U, so I'll just leave it at that. And then down here, I have, look, front left Blue Snowball, which is awesome. And just to verify that those are actually working here in Reaper, here is the Samson Q2U. So you can see that that is the top one. And we'll actually want to name this Samson or Q2U, whatever you wanna name it, so that you remember which one is which. And then from down here, we can type Blue Snowball. Okay, so now I have the tracks named, and if I just tap on the Samson Q2U, you'll see that the Samson Q2U is recording there. And if I tap on the blue snowball, it's just the blue snowball that's recording there, which is great. Now, if I wanna adjust the input volume of either one of these microphones, because they're USB microphones that don't have a preamp or a gain knob on them, I would have to do that for my system preferences. So I can see that these are a little hot. So I'm gonna come to sound here for my system preferences in my Mac computer. And from here, this is where I can actually adjust the volume a little bit. And when you're in your room with two or more people recording on your USB microphones, you definitely don't want the microphones facing each other if possible. And the farther you can get away from each other, the better sound you're gonna get. So let's start here, and I'm gonna have the blue microphone here, and we'll pretend that that is a person recording on this side, and then here I am recording on this side. And you'll want it nice and close to your mouth. Also, if you keep them nice and close to your mouth, you're gonna get less bleed into each other's microphones the closer you are. And we'll go ahead and press record here in Reaper, and I'll just undo all these little distortion acts, and we'll press record. And here I am now talking onto the Samson microphone, and you can see my volume levels are way too loud, so I would have to either back up from the microphone or adjust the preamp. You'll also notice that there is some bleed happening on the blue snowball, and that's perfectly normal. That will happen anytime you record in the same room with more than one microphone. Then I'll put this one aside and just pull this blue snowball. And with the blue snowball, here I am recording. You'll see that there's still some little levels getting into the Samson Q2U, but this looks really good. And now you can see that I'm able to record two separate tracks. And really, you can do this with as many microphones as you have. You can have 4, 6 USB microphones all recording. This is a great solution for independent podcasters because you don't have to buy an expensive audio interface. And many people nowadays, especially since we're all being forced into remote recording, many people have a USB microphone. So it's a great alternative for you. I hope you found that super helpful. Please comment here if you have any other questions. Also, if you're interested in learning more about Reaper and getting to be very fast and very efficient and professional at recording and editing your podcast in Reaper, I actually put together a Reaper course. It's called Reaper for Podcasters. And you can check that out by going to podsoundschool.com/r4p. Okay, there you have it, Podski. And until next time, don't forget to hit subscribe here on this channel. We post all sorts of great podcasting videos here every week for your enjoyment. All right, happy casting.